Good morning, Lord. Good morning, everyone. And good morning to the faculty and staff and to all the students of Pilgrim Christian College. Welcome to Pilgrim Hour. Shall we bow down our head? Let us pray. As we lay in bed, thank you that you, O God, has opened our eyes. We close them once again in reverence to your holy name. We worship you this moment, O God. You are gracious and your mercies are new every morning. We are excited about your will being fulfilled in our life this new day. Show me your great works, O God. Fill us with your presence all day long. Increase our faith and overwhelm us with your strength. Hallelujah to your name. We rejoice in your greatness and praise you, O Lord, for you are the source of all good things in life. Fill our mouth with words of worship and let others see your mighty works in our life on this day. Glory be to God Almighty. Amen. Once again, good morning to each and everyone who are with us this early morning on Pilgrim Hour. Now, due to the fact until this time, the entire community is affected in one way or another by the coronavirus pandemic raging throughout the world. For many, this is a challenge to our faith and our understanding. How can this be happening? Where is God in all of this? How should we respond as people of faith? Now, we offer these reflections to help believers in Christ think more deeply from a perspective of faith on the events now shaping our lives in big and little ways. And we will continue adding reflections over the coming days. Now, for this reason, may I alter the topic that we had discussed last time. Now, the text that I have been used is found in Matthew chapter 7, verse 24 to 25. And it says, "Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house. Yet it did not fall because it had its foundation on the rock." Now, the passage followed by the contrast of one who built his house on the sand. The wind and the rains came and the house collapsed. It's a clear contrast that leads anyone to conclude that having your house built on solid rock is much better. Now, in this text, there are two groups of people. When Jesus is laboring the point that there are two groups of people and both groups have been exposed to the word of God, both groups have heard the words of Jesus and what he has commanded. Yet, they're distinguished by the response to his words. That's why this text is particularly relevant to everyone in PCC community and even outside the PCC community. All of you are hearing the words of Jesus. You're being exposed to his teachings, and many of you have probably been exposed to far more than what you have heard thus far today. Now, actually, the text is part of the Sermon on the Mount of Jesus. And if you read the whole chapter 5 to 7, it has a complete ministry of Jesus, the teaching, the preaching, and the healing. And the last part, which I read, is a word of challenge to the people who follow and listen to him. Now in this account, Jesus used a metaphor. The house is your or our life. And the question it raises is simply, how strong am I? How strong am I to face the storms, hardships, and crosses that will inevitably come my way? Now, when life is easy and all goes smoothly, we do not necessarily need great inner strength. When money is plentiful, we have many friends. We have our health and our family all gets along. Life can be good. And in that case, life can be easy. But there are few who can go through life without facing some storm. And in the same way, being a follower of Jesus will not keep you from rain and floods and winds and all kinds of trials in your life. But when you do experience those things, you will have a peace and a strength, and you will stand and not fall if you have built your life upon the rock. When that happens, our inner strength is tested, and the strength of our inner convictions is required. Now in this story from Jesus, or account from Jesus, the rains, the floods, and winds that buffeted the house are actually a good thing. Why? Because they allow the foundations of the house to manifest its stability. So it is with us. The foundations of our lives must be our fidelity, faithfulness, or trustworthiness to the Word of God. The question is, do you believe the Word of God? Have you pondered it, studied it, internalized it, and allow God's Word to become the foundations of your life? Now, Jesus makes it clear that we will have a solid foundation only when we listen, meditate to His words, and act on them. Reflect today upon how deeply you believe all that Jesus says. Do you trust in every word He has spoken? Do you believe Him enough to rely upon His promises, even in the midst of life's greatest challenges? All He says in Scripture is true, and those truths are what we need to create a firm foundation for the rest of our lives. Now, if you're not sure, maybe then this is a good day to recommit yourselves to the prayerful reading of His Word. Amen. On behalf of Spiritual Formation Department Office, thank you for watching. God bless, stay safe, and good morning.